All right, we have here the JBL Charge 4 that is fake slash not authentic, and the JBL Charge 4 that is authentic that you can find at a Walmart, a Target, or Best Buy, or any major electronic retailer in your area. So what makes this fake versus this being real? Let's take a look. Let's open it here. So we will slide it out. Looks like it just slides to the left or the right. Set that there and get into this box. All right, we have a, looks like USB to a micro USB and a auxiliary to auxiliary port there. Let's get into the speaker itself. Take it out of the plastic covering. Let's get that out of the way. So you have a M, which I'm not exactly sure what that does, a minus volume, plus volume, and a play pause. There's also what looks like a power button there and the JBL Connect logo. We'll have to see if it does JBL Connect. One passive radiator here on one side, a passive radiator on the other side. It's got the LEDs here. That should be for how much power is left in the battery. Flip it over to the back and open that up. By the way, this should be so that it's IPX7 rated for waterproof. This doesn't seem like it's really tight. It might be flimsy. I doubt that it's really going to be waterproof. So you've got a micro USB, aux port, USB, and this looks like you can put a memory card in there for some music. So let's take a look at the differences between this and the authentic JBL Charge 4. All right, the authentic JBL Charge 4, let's open that up so that we can compare them. Here. All right, it says play and charge endlessly. The Charge 4 has a really nice foam cover here. Get into the box, and right away you can tell that this is significantly heavier than the not authentic version. It's also gonna be significantly darker. It's got the connect, it's got volume down, volume up, play, pause. Let's take a look at both of them side by side here. You can see on one side, it's got the JBL on the fake version, and then the other side, just the logo. Let's flip them around. And they both do say JBL, but you can see that the fake version just has the JBL logo in black versus the authentic version has it in gray. Taking a look at the bottom, it's pretty similar. This is gonna be recessed, it's smooth, so the power bank LEDs that light up are going to be a little bit smoother than here. These are actual holes that you can touch. This is also translucent, and this is a dark gray. Let's take a look at the back of the Charge 4. This is the version that is IPX7 waterproof, and it looks like that is actually a pretty good water seal. So let's open that up, and definitely there's a difference there. You've got USB-C, you've got an aux auxiliary port, and then a USB port. And this USB port on the one that's authentic, that's definitely to charge your phone, and that's going to be to charge your speaker itself. All right, let's power them up and see what we think. All right, so we have powered up the fake JBL Charge 4. It's really easy to pair. You just hit the M button, it shows up as Charge 4, and then you pair it. So what I want to do is I want to do a sound test. Obviously, the JBL Charge 4 that's fake versus the JBL Charge 4 that's authentic. Let's see how it sounds. Let's get this going here.
So we get it. I'ma get it. So we get it. So we get it.
Okay, so right away I can tell that there's sound that is just coming from the front of the speaker. The passive radiators did not move at all. They're pretty much stationary, and it sounds like a cell phone, maybe a Motorola flip phone from about 2002. So yeah, the sound volume is absolutely horrible, and it's garbage. So let's take a look at what an authentic JBL Charge 4 Bluetooth speaker should sound like. All right, so to pair the authentic JBL Charge 4 speaker, you just hit the Bluetooth button and it'll search and come up as Charge 4. Let's take a different, let's take a look at the sound on the Charge 4, the real Charge 4 versus the authentic Charge 4, which we were very unimpressed by.
So we get it. I'ma get it. So we get it.
Alright, so we needed about 2 seconds to figure out that this sounds 10 times better. You could see the passive radiators on both sides were putting out a lot of sound. And the JBL Charge 4 has one large speaker here. I think the 3 had two smaller ones here, but it sounds absolutely a whole lot better. So, in conclusion, you've got a speaker that's about $35, which is what I paid for this. And this retailed for about $250. Then it went down to $199, but you can find them on sale for anywhere between $119 and about $149. Is it worth your money? Absolutely. And now you know the differences between the fake and the real JBL Charge 4. And if you do buy one secondhand or used, you will not get had or cheated, because you can definitely now tell the difference between a real Charge 4 and a one that's trash. This is the JBL Clip 3. You can see the comparison as far as size is concerned. It is about, I'm going to say, one-fifth the size of the JBL Charge 4. This sounds 10 times better than the fake version of the JBL Charge 4. I'll let you hear it really quickly. And typically, this is retailing anywhere between $29.99 and $49.99, which was what it retails for new. And I'll let you hear the sound difference between the fake JBL Charge 4 and just the small JBL Clip 3.
So we get it. I'ma get it. So we get it.
So as you can hear, it's absolutely no contest. For what you'd pay for this, you can find this on sale, and it'll take up one-third, one-fourth the space of the fake JBL Charge 4. So in conclusion, definitely go with authentic JBL product. And if you don't want to spend that much money, go ahead and get a JBL Clip 3, because it'll outperform a fake JBL Charge 4.